Hi folks, hope you are doing great. In this video, I'm going to talk about the main differences between service provider initiated web SSO and the IT provider initiated web SSO related to SAML 2.0. I assume you have a high level idea about how the SAML SSO works, so I'm not going to explain that. I assume that knowledge and will explain the differences between SP initiated web SSO and IDP initiated web SSO. One difference is quite obvious. SP initiated SSO is initiated by the service provider. For example, if you want to log into your Salesforce service provider from your corporate identity provider, then first you go to the service provider or Salesforce. And then Salesforce will create a SAML request and send it to IDP. So that is initiated by Salesforce or the service provider. IDP initiated SSO works initiated from the IDP. First you log into the IDP and then you click a link there. Then IDP will create a SAML response and send it directly to the service provider. Okay. So I'll show you a couple of demos in either case. First, let me explain the scenario a little more using a diagram. Here, first you have the service provider, SP, and then the IDP. Okay, and we need to have a user. Let's see whether okay, maybe let's get a user. Okay, he's good. Okay, so this is a user. Come to this side, then here, and you have the user. In SP initiated SSO, the user will first go to the service provider. So this is from the browser. It will just do like get to that particular URL, and then SP service provider will redirect you to the IDP. So this will be a 302. This goes through the browser. So user gets redirected to the IDP, and here this is the SAML request. Okay. And now you authenticate to the IDP, and again IDP will redirect you back to the service provider based on the SAML binding you use. So this is another 302. Once again goes through the browser, and this will carry the SAML response. Okay. In both the cases, SAML request and SAML response, they go through the browser. So this is how the SP initiated web SSO works. Now let's see how the IDP initiated web SSO works. In that case, let me take a copy of this diagram. In IDP initiated web SSO, we don't have a SAML request. The user will first go to the IDP. Click on a link on the IDP. Maybe do a get. Then you first log into the IDP, and then you click a link on the IDP to log into the service provider. Right? Then the IDP will create a SAML response. There's no SAML request. Create a SAML response, and will redirect the user to the service provider. Right? So if you look at these two diagrams, you can see there's a SAML request involved in the SP initiated web SSO. There is no SAML request in the IDP initiated web SSO. then why would some prefer one over the other, right? Even it took some time for Salesforce to support SP initiated web-based SEO. Mostly the SaaS providers, they prefer IDP initiated web-based SEO. The reason is, in a SaaS app, under a single domain like salesforce.com, there can be multiple tenants or multiple companies, right? So if I'm an employee of WSO2 and I want to log into my company's Salesforce account, I just go to salesforce.com and type my username and password, and looking at my username, Salesforce will find out what my tenant is, and after the authentication, it will dispatch me to my own tenant, right? Even somebody else from a different company, like let's say Bank of America employee, if he wants to log into Salesforce, he will type his Bank of America username and password from Salesforce. Then Salesforce will find out the tenant after validating the credentials, and after that, the user will get dispatched to his own tenant. So that can be done in Salesforce, which is a multi-tenanted SaaS app, only after identifying who the user is, right? Under the same URL, right? Both of us type the same URL. If that is the case, Salesforce or that particular SaaS app cannot find my tenant or the company without me authenticating to the service provider. I need to give at least some hint. At least I need to give my username. Then only the tenant, the multi-tenanted SaaS app can find out what my tenant is, right? So in a SaaS app, each tenant can have its own IDP, right? So this IDP is registered under the WSO2 Salesforce domain, right? So now to redirect me from Salesforce to the WSO2 IDP, when I do a get, Salesforce should somehow find out my tenant and find the link or find the data about my IDP and create a SAML request which is good to access my IDP, right? To do that, Salesforce should first find what my IDP is, right? So if Salesforce shares the same URL for all its customers, you cannot do that because you cannot uniquely identify a tenant by looking at the same URL, right? So that is why 3 years back, Salesforce introduced something called My Domain, right? So then each company will have its own URL, right? So when I type my own URL here, now Salesforce knows which tenant I belong to just looking at the URL. Then it can load the identity provider configurations registered under my tenant in my Salesforce account, and then it will create a SAML request which should mesh my IDP and redirect me here. Then I authenticate to my IDP and my IDP will build a SAML response and redirect me to the Salesforce or the service provider, right? So that's how the SP initiated web-based SEO works in SaaS app scenarios. But if you want to use IDP initiated SSO, service providers need not to deal with those complexities in finding out which tenant the user belongs to or which account the user belongs to before authenticating the user. You first log into your IDP. In IDP, you log into your own tenant, right? And there in your tenant, you register your service provider. And when you register your service provider there, if this is a WSO2 IDP, and I register my WSO2 Salesforce configuration here as my service provider, right? Then when I click on that link here, the IDP will generate a SAML response which matches the requirement of my Salesforce WSO2 account and just send the SAML response here. And in the SAML response, it will identify who I am. Then Salesforce can directly log me into that particular tenant, right? So from SaaS app side, service provider side, this is less complex. You don't need to deal with initial complexities. You don't need to generate any SAML request. You don't need to identify user's tenant or the account before he actually logs in, right? But in reality, both the patterns are popular. Google Labs, Salesforce, both support screen-shared web SSO. Salesforce supports both, and Amazon supports IDP-initiated web SSO. Let me quickly show you a demo. First, I will show you how the SP-initiated web SSO works with Salesforce. I have already done a demo on this, so I'm not going into details. And I'm using WSO2 Identity Server here as my identity provider. If you hear about WSO2 Identity Server for the first time, it's an open source identity and access management product released under the most business friendly Apache 2.0 license. You can download it from WSO2.com and then go to products, identity and access management, and from here you can download it. The latest version at the time of this recording is IS 530. Once you download the product, you only need to have JDK 1.8 and then you need to set up the Java home. That's it. Then you can start the server. I already have downloaded the product and started it, right? Now once you start the server, you can log into the management console using localhost 9443 on HTTPS. Okay. And log in with admin. Those are the default credentials. In a production deployment, you can deploy identity server or an LDAP server, Active Directory, or even a database. Now I have registered all these service providers here. I have Salesforce and AWS. So here you can see this is my login URL to Salesforce. This is coming from the salesforce.com, and this is the domain for my account in Salesforce, right? So if I just copy this URL and paste it here, and you can see you can track all the messages using this SSO Tracer plugin. Now if I enter, now you can see I got redirected to my identity provider, WSO2 Identity Server, running in my local machine. Now I can log in with some credentials coming from WSO2 Identity Server, and I got redirected to Salesforce. Okay. Now let me show you the SAML flow there. This is a SSO plugin, SSO Tracer. This is a Firefox plugin. Here you can see the SAML request, right? So this SAML request was initiated by Salesforce, right? This SAML authentication request. And this is the SAML response initiated by the identity provider or WSO2 Identity Server. Okay, so you can see both SAML request and SAML response in this message flow. Next, I will show you how to log into AWS with WSO2 Identity Server. And this is my login URL. Here you can see the login URL is not pointing to AWS. It's pointing to my local IDP. So first I come to IDP and log into the IDP, and then IDP will redirect me to this particular URL, right? And this URL should be the SP entity ID which I register in the WSO2 Identity Server as a service provider. And if I go back here, okay, open up a private window. Let me start the SAML Tracer again. And if I click here, and log in with Peter again. Right, you can see I first went to the identity server. Identity server generated SAML response, and now I am logged into AWS. And if you look at the SAML message flow here, you will only see the SAML response. Here you can see only the SAML response, no SAML request there, right? So this is a SAML response initiated by the WSO2 identity server. And you can log into AWS using the SAML response which comes from the WSO2 Identity Server. So that is how SP initiated web SSO and IDP initiated web SSO work with XAML. This concludes the demo today. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask them, post them to the comment section below this video. Thank you very much.